Hey, good people of YTBC, it's Harriet Herfer. I'm back doing a VR for Piping Pirate. He's doing a return golf. He's back. And he's interested in our employment history. Smoking my Morgan, my naked Morgan. I am still smoking some of that pirate cake plug that, I think they call it pirate plug, that Quint the Frozen Vacky Blender sent with the Danny Shore raffle that I won. Tasting more of a Latakia now, and it's just so, I mean, I don't know. I think for me, Latakia is smoky, but it's creamy too. And it's so good. This is so good. Dude, so good. So, Mr. Piping Pirate, I have an exciting first job. I lived a block away from Wendy's restaurant. It was my first job. So I could walk to work, put an application in there, and they hired me right away. So I worked there. Probably about a year. I really had a great dislike for it. Minimum wage, you know. Didn't want to stay there very long. Stayed there longer than I really wanted to. But, you know, for a first job, it was what it was. So, and you wanted to know about the job that we hated the most. Well, there were a couple. One that I hated the most, sure. The one that I hated, I did for a very short period of time, I did telemarketing. And I hate telemarketers so bad, but I worked at a school, and I ran the clinic at a school. And in the summer, I'd get a job to supplement my income. And I worked at a telemarketing agency where I was very, very successful. But the next telemarketing job I got, I worked at, it was not so great. It wasn't because I wasn't successful at it, because I was. I think I just have a voice on the phone that people want to spend their money, apparently. I had a hard time with the fact that I felt like I was trying to talk somebody into something that they didn't really need. So I had a problem with that. And then I was so good at it at one of the jobs that they set me up in my own office in my own room. They send out postcards, and instead of me calling people, they had people call me. And they asked me to say that my name that wasn't my name. And I just felt that was dishonest. I didn't like it, it made me uncomfortable. And I had to quit. I just couldn't do it anymore. So I hated doing that. I don't know. Anyway, and I also had a job that I loved and I hated at the same time, so I'm gonna talk about that one as well. So Hugh and I did long haul. We drove semis cross country, a semi cross country. We were team drivers. Did it for a short time. The reason we did it for a short time is because the company said that we would be home, you know, every other weekend. No, it did not happen. So, And at one point we were out 52 days. We were about an hour from home without a load to pick up. And we asked if we could just, you know, come on home and wait it out there, and they said no. So we said, well, where would you like to pick your truck up? Because we're going home. And that was the end of that. It wasn't just that, though. I got so tired of waking up in the morning, climbing out of the cab of that truck, smelling the combination of urine and rubber. Because guys would get up in the morning or in the middle of the night and they would pee on the tires, and it just, I was like, man, I mean, I know. But you're parked at a truck stop, come on, guys. It's a guy thing. I guess women could do it, they do it too, I don't know. Maybe. So there's that. So the reason I hated it was for those two reasons. However, pause for effect. No. However, it was one of my favorite jobs. The fact that I didn't have a boss over my shoulder. And I was with you. So it worked out really well. I mean, what better job could you have than to spend literally 24/7 with the person that you love? You had some of the best times driving that stupid truck. We laughed so hard. I got to see things that I would never have seen. I had never seen a cactus. Low flying aircraft there. I'd never seen a cactus, antelope, a lot of antelope in one place. I've never seen a cotton field. Parked the truck, hopped out of the truck, ran over and picked a piece of cotton. I still have it. Look. And I was so excited. I'd never been to, what do you call it? A casino? Couldn't even think of the name of it. I'd never been to a casino before. I mean, I went to states that I'd never been to before, and I haven't been back since. There was, which I found hilarious, I forget where it was. Was it Oklahoma? There was a Love's truck stop in Hooker. And I don't know, I just found that hilarious, but so many different places I got to see. And the worst place that we delivered to, which is totally nasty, was an egg farm. Oh God. The horrible, horrible smell that came from that place. It's not good. Not good. And I've smelled some nasty things in my life because I used to be I was a firefighter and an EMT. And between that egg farm and dead body, the egg farm was the worst. That's how bad it was. So I can't imagine what a slaughterhouse would smell like. Some of those people that work at those places, I don't know how they do it. But the job that I do now, boy, I really got off on that one, didn't I? Ramble. The job that I do now enables me to spend time with my mother. She's elderly, and my father passed away a number of years ago, so I like to spend time with my mother. And as she's getting older, she doesn't drive anymore, so I'm her chauffeur. I work at a friend's comic book store and gaming store. Believe it or not, I do. Do the weekly intake of stock. I do the payroll. Not as much as I used to. I wait on customers, but not as much as I used to, because I'm doing a lot of office work. And then I also do sales on eBay for the store, which I do from home. It opens up, you know, gives me the ability to choose my own hours there, you know, in that regard. So it helps me out a lot. So I feel fortunate that I have this job that I can do that with and be there for my mother when she needs me. So she's one of my best friends, so works out pretty good. So that is it. It's not exciting. I've had some unusual jobs in my life, some bad jobs, but those are the best and the worst, I think. Smoked some good tobacco, smoked some bad tobacco. This is one of the better ones right here. I'm going to savor every flake of that tobacco, every little piece of that tobacco. I'm going to savor. It is wonderful. So, Smoking Fireman, thank you for the opportunity to enter this giveaway that you're doing. And I wish everybody luck in it. You guys have a great one. And go sub a newbie. I'll have to catch you on the next one.